हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू येट अनदर लेक्चर ऑफ पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स. इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट 16th ग्रुप एलिमेंट्स विच हैज़ ऑक्सीजन, सल्फर, सेलूरियम, टेलूरियम एंड पोलोनियम, राइट. इन दैट वीडियो वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन द कंपाउंड्स रिलेटेड टू ऑक्सीजन लाइक डाई ऑक्सीजन ऑक्साइड्स एंड इवन सल्फर डाइऑक्साइड. एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन द कंपाउंड्स रिलेटेड टू सल्फर विच इज़ नथिंग बट एलोट्रोप्स ऑफ सल्फर, राइट. ऑल ऑफ दोज वॉज 16th ग्रुप एलिमेंट. द नेक्स्ट ग्रुप ऑफ द पी ब्लॉक इज 17th ग्रुप एलिमेंट्स. हु कम्स अंडर 17th ग्रुप एलिमेंट्स आर हैलोजन्स विच आर नथिंग बट फ्लोरिन, क्लोरिन, ब्रोमीन, आयोडीन एंड एस्टाटाइन, राइट. दिस लेट अस फॉरगेट अबाउट दिस, बट वी विल कंसिडर ओनली दिस फर्स्ट फोर, राइट. फ्लोरिन, क्लोरिन, ब्रोमीन एंड आयोडीन कम्स अंडर 17th ग्रुप एलिमेंट्स, राइट. वॉट इज द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ दिस एलिमेंट इज NS2NP5, राइट. सो आउट ऑफ 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स दे आर हैविंग हाउ मेनी इन देयर वैलेंस शेल? 7, राइट. दे आर हैविंग only a shortage of one electron to get the noble gas electronic configuration. That means if they can get one electron, that means their octet will be satisfied and their electronic configuration will be exactly like the nearest noble gas. And after this group only you have noble gases whose octet is completely filled. They come just before the noble gases, and in that particular period they are having the smallest size. In that particular period, when I say in that particular, in the second period the smallest size is of a fluorine, third period the smallest size is for chlorine, same way bromine, iodine, right. In their particular period, starting from the first element of the period till last element, who has the smallest size are halogens of that particular period, right. Therefore their nuclear charge or effective nuclear charge will also be very high in that particular element if you compare the period elements, right. But now let us look at the elements present in this group. What happens to their atomic size, what happens to their electronegativity, and same way ionization enthalpy. We know that their electronic configuration is having a shortage of only one electron to get the nearest noble gas, right. What is the name of these elements? They are halogens, right. So atomic radius from top to bottom, what is the general trend? It increases from top to bottom. So even for this group also it's the same, which is it increases from top to bottom, and fluorine has the smallest size compared to others. In fluorine, more than expected it should have a small size, but its size is even more smaller than the expected. Why? Because it is having highest electronegativity in the complete periodic table, therefore it is smallest in size, right. So atomic radius increases from top to bottom. Next, what happens to electronegativity? Electronegativity is highest for fluorine and it decreases down the group. Fluorine has highest electronegativity not just in this group, it has highest electronegativity in the complete periodic table. That means fluorine combines with any element of the periodic table will behave in the form of a negatively charged ion, and whoever combines with the fluorine will become positive, right. That is the reason of, that is because of its high electronegativity, right. Highest electronegativity in periodic table is fluorine, and from top to bottom electronegativity decreases, right. What is the next property? Ionization energy, right. If atomic radius increases from top to bottom, ionization energy decreases from top to bottom, and who has the highest electron highest ionization energy is fluorine. It decreases from top to bottom. Ionization energy decreases from top to bottom. What is electron gain enthalpy? The electron gain enthalpy means their ability to gain the electron, means the energy released after gaining an electron is called as electron gain enthalpy, which is very high for halogens. Electron gain enthalpy is also very high for halogens. Now what we will see, these are its general properties. Now let us look at its chemical properties in which we will see how halogens react with hydrogen. How do they react? Before studying its chemical properties, we have to know its oxidation states. If oxidation states are clear, then studying the chemical properties becomes very easy. Halogens, what are the general oxidation states of halogens? The halogens show a general oxidation state of -1, +1, +3, +5, and +7, right? These are the general oxidation states of all the halogens. In that halogen, fluorine shows only and always -1 oxidation states. Other oxidation states of positive charge is not possible for fluorine. Why? Because positive charge indicates that they are losing 1 electron or 3 electron or 5 electron or 7 electron, which fluorine can never do. Fluorine always can gain the electron, right? When will halogens show these oxidation states? Whenever they combine with either fluorine, say for example, these elements, if they combine with either fluorine or with other electronegative element like oxygen, if these element combines with fluorine or with oxygen, they show positive oxidation states, because these two are electronegative, so they will have negative oxidation states, -1, then this should have +1 oxidation state, or +2 or +3 or +4 +5 +6 +7, not all but odd numbers, +1, 3, 5, and 7, right? But fluorine will always show -1. Why fluorine cannot show the remaining oxidation state? Why others are able to show is because of the presence of d orbitals also. One reason fluorine don't show other oxidation states. Why? One reason is high electronegativity means they will always gain the electron. So this is only possible for fluorine. Others are losing electrons are not possible. Another reason is d orbitals are absent in fluorine. If d orbitals are absent that in fluorine, that means the d orbitals present in the other halogens will be used and the octet is expanded. Let us see how it is getting expanded. What is the general electronic configuration of halogens? NS2 NP5. Suppose we will say 2S2 2P5 is for fluorine, that means 3S2 3P5 is for chlorine, is it? Right. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. That means 3D is present beside 3P even though it is empty, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Whenever this chlorine, or not just chlorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, whenever the remaining 3 element combines with electronegative elements like fluorine or oxygen, the electrons get expanded and their octet changes. How it changes? This electron jumps here. What happens? The electronic configuration will be changed into this. There was an electron here which comes here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? There was an electron present here, comes here. Now it has how many? Octet got expanded. After the octet got expanded, how many unpaired electrons does chlorine have now? 1, 2, and 3, right? If one unpaired electron is lost, how many unpaired electrons here? Without changing the octet, one unpaired electron lost means what is the oxidation state? Plus 1. But now if it is shifting from here to here, 1, 2, 3 unpaired electrons. 3 unpaired electrons are present. If all the 3 unpaired electrons are lost, then what will be the oxidation state? Plus 3. Same way, another possibility is this electron also jumps here. Now how many unpaired electrons will chlorine or bromine or iodine have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? This electron also comes now. Now how many unpaired electrons are present here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So unpaired electrons are 5 unpaired electrons. If all the 5 unpaired electrons are lost, what will be the oxidation state? Plus 5. Same way, this electron also jumps here. What happens then? One, two, three. Now you count the number of unpaired electrons present. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 unpaired electrons, and if all the 7 unpaired electrons are lost, the oxidation state will be plus 7. Right? 7 unpaired electrons are present. If all the 7 unpaired electrons are lost, the oxidation state will be plus 7. These are different oxidation states of halogens apart from fluorine, because fluorine cannot show plus oxidation, positive oxidation state. It shows only minus 1, which means it will only gain electrons, right? And it doesn't mean that other halogens don't show this. Every halogen shows minus 1 oxidation state, but the other oxidation states are shown by the remaining only, but not fluorine. The reason is because of its high electronegativity and because of absence of d orbitals. Electronegativity is also very high, which cannot remove the electrons. And d orbitals are also absent because of the movement of electrons, which is not possible in fluorine, right? These are the oxidation states. Now we will see the chemical properties of these group elements, which means how halogens combine with hydrogen, how halogens combine with oxygen, how halogens combine with each other, and how halogens combine with metals and nonmetals. Right? Let us see that now. Now let us look at the chemical properties of halogens. What is the first chemical property? Is how they react with hydrogen. How they react with hydrogen, or what is their reactivity towards hydrogen? Whenever halogens react with hydrogen, what do they form? They form hydrohalous acid or hydrohalic acid. If X is F means hydrofluoric acid, Cl means hydrochloric acid, Br means hydrobromic acid, and hydroiodic acid, right? They form halic acid. Whenever halogens react with hydrogen, they form hydrochloric or hydrobromic or hydroiodic, such type of acids. Now let me take the different halogens in place of X. Let me take HF. That means they are all the acids. HF is also acid, HCl is also acid, HBr and HI. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. If all of them are acids, what is the strength of acid from top to bottom, or what happens to the acidity of these type of acid? That means which one is the stronger acid, which one is the weaker acid, that you have to judge, right? The acidity of these acids are judged based on the strength of the bond between HF, strength of the bond between HCl, between HBr and HI. How can you measure the strength of the bond? Look at the electronegativity of chlorine or fluorine or halogen, right? Electronegativity of fluorine is very high, is it? Electronegativity of fluorine is very high, therefore the bond will be very tight. Therefore, what is the job of acid? To release H plus ions, right? Therefore, H plus cannot be released easily because the electronegativity of fluorine is higher than chlorine. Therefore, fluorine is less acidic than HCl, then which is less acidic than HBr, which is less acidic than HI. The bond dissociation energy or the bond enthalpy to break the bond is very high for HF, then a little less for HCl, then a little less for HBr, then a little less for HI. It is very easy to break this bond. That means it is also very easy to liberate H plus ions. If this bond can be broken very easily, that means H plus ions also can be liberated easily. Therefore, the acid of this type is the strongest acid and HF is the weakest acid among them. Is it right? This is the strength of the acid and how it reacts with hydrogen. Which one is weak acid? HF. And which one is strong acid? HI. Now let us go to the reactivity of halogens towards oxygen. When they react with oxygen, what do they form? They form different type of oxides. They form different type of oxides are formed with different halogen. What is the, which type of halogen is combining with oxygen, that type of oxides you get. So what you have to do, fluorine forms which type of oxides, chlorine forms which type of oxide, bromine forms which type of oxide, and iodine form which type of oxides, you have to see. Now let us look at fluorine. Okay, so generally by writing the name of any compound, suppose I say sodium chloride, that means Na plus Cl minus. What is the name of this compound? Whatever is positive charge should be written first, sodium, and whatever is the negative charge should be written last in this way, ide should comes, right? So when you make oxide of fluorine, fluorine forms two type of oxide. One is OF2, other is O2F2. What is the name of this type of fluoride? In between this type of fluoride, this is less stable, this is more stable. So this is common. What is the name of this compound? Fluorine oxide, you should say, or oxygen fluoride, you should say. Fluorine oxide is correct, or oxygen fluoride is correct. You should add the word ide to more electronegative element. So in between oxygen and fluorine, who is more electronegative here? Fluorine is more electronegative. So you should have fluoride as the end, not oxide. With every other compound of the periodic table, if oxygen combines, it is becoming oxide. But oxygen combines with one element which is fluorine to not give oxide. What it gives is fluoride. Every time oxygen is acting like negative charge to call as oxide, to be called as oxide, but not with fluorine, because its electronegativity is lesser than fluorine, greater than everyone else, but lesser than fluorine, right? So the name of the compound is oxygen fluoride, in which oxygen for the first time gets +2 charge and fluorine gets -2. -2 means one fluorine -1, another fluorine -1. Therefore its name should be oxygen fluoride, and this is also oxygen fluoride, but the formula is different. Now let us see what type of oxides chlorine, bromine and iodine makes. As the other elements are having less electronegativity than oxygen, So now let us look at the oxides of other elements. We have seen for fluorine, as fluorine is more electronegative than oxygen, the name of that oxide should be oxygen fluoride. Okay, oxygen fluoride, monooxygen fluoride and dioxygen fluoride is the name. But after fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, if these three halogens combine with oxygen, whose electronegativity will be higher? Oxygen's electronegativity is higher or halogen's electronegativity is higher? The oxygen's electronegativity is higher than these three. Therefore, such a type of compound should be called as dichlorine oxide, chlorine dioxide, dichlorine hexoxide. Such type of name should be written. You should not say oxygen chloride. If you say oxygen chloride, that means chloride should get minus charge, oxygen should get plus charge, which is wrong. It was exception only for these, not for others, right? So now let us look at the type of oxides chlorine makes. Chlorine makes these type of oxides in which oxygen gets negative charge. One oxygen means what is the negative charge? Minus 2. Two halogen means plus 2. That means each halogen should have plus 1 charge. Going to the next, each oxygen minus 2, total charge is minus 4, that means on halogen the charge is plus 4. Each halogen minus 2, that means total charge is minus 12, that means on each chlorine the charge is plus 6. Same way, minus each oxygen minus 2, that means minus 14 is the charge on oxygen, that means plus 7 is the charge on halogen. Two chlorines, therefore plus 7 becomes plus 14. The remaining, the next element is bromine. What type of oxide bromine makes? Bromine, monoxide, dioxide and trioxide. In that, what is the oxidation state on bromine? Oxygen means minus 2. That means on each bromine, plus 1 becomes plus 2. Next is minus 2 into 2 is minus 4. That means on bromine, the oxidation state is plus 4, right? Then the next is minus 6, that means on bromine it is plus 6. The next is oxides of iodine, in which what is the oxidation state? Minus 8 plus 4. Minus 10 plus 5. Minus 14 plus 7. These are the oxidation states. Some halogens can show odd number oxidation state in their oxide, and some halogens will show even number oxidation state in their oxide. Both of them are possible. How it is possible, we have already seen during the expansion of its octet, how many electrons they lose, that is the oxidation state. Most common is odd number oxidation state, but even this is also known. Right, plus 4, plus 6, plus 2, that is also known in oxides of halogen. This is how they react with oxygen to form oxides. Going to the next chemical property of halogen is how they react with metals. Halogens react very excellently with metal, because halogen being more electronegative, what is the nature of halogens? To accept electrons. What is the nature of metals? Metals are electropositive in nature, so they are ready to donate electrons. Halogens are electronegative in nature, they are ready to accept electrons. When both of them combine, you will get halides of that metal. That means you will get salts in which halogen gains the electron. And suppose I say I take sodium metal and chlorine. So what happens? If you take both of them as a combination, sodium loses an electron to become Na plus and chlorine gains an electron to become Na minus, which gives you NaCl. How many? 2 NaCl, right? Both of them are a very good combination in which halogen combines with metal. Not just sodium, it can combine with next group called magnesium or calcium also, right? Here also magnesium loses 2 electrons to become magnesium plus 2, and halogen gains 2 electrons to become Cl minus. What is the formula? MgCl2, right? So, halogens react with all the salts. Here I have taken the halogen of chlorine only to give you chloride salts. Sodium chloride, magnesium chloride and such. Not just chlorine, even other halogens also can form. For fluorine also can react with sodium to form sodium fluoride, magnesium fluoride and such. And the reactivity of halogens towards metal. If you want to compare which halogen is more reactive with the metal and which halogen is less reactive with the metal, it is this order. Right? Fluorine is highly reactive even though it has more electronegativity and small size. Because of small size, there are inter-electronic repulsions in fluorine atom. Therefore, the reactivity of F2 is higher than Cl2, which is higher than Br2, which is higher than I2. And halogens can react with any metal. This is S block, but from D block also they can react. If I take copper chloride, zinc chloride, manganese chloride, all the elements of D block also can react with halogens to form their halides. Okay, so you should always say sodium chloride, sodium fluoride, sodium bromide and sodium iodide, and such type of salts will be formed whenever halogens react with any metal. Right, now looking at the next property, which is very important and characteristic of halogens, is how they combine with each other. Right, one halogen combines with other halogen to form a compound. That compound is not called as hydride, that compound is not called as oxide, and that compound is not called as even halide also. Then what is the name of that compound? The name of that compound is interhalogen compounds. The name of that compounds is interhalogen compounds. What does that mean? That means two types of halogens are combining with each other to form a molecule. Which type of halogens will combine? If I take fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine, the general formula of that type of compounds are AX, AX3, AX5 and AX7. Right? This is the general formula of interhalogen compounds, in which what is A is less electronegative element. Less electronegative element is in the center. What is X? More electronegative element. Right? So in this group, who is the most electronegative element? Fluorine. That means you have to make interhalogen compounds in which fluorine is taken with all others. Right? So what type of examples can you take? Fluorine is this one. So fluorine can combine with chlorine, fluorine can combine with bromine, fluorine can combine with iodine. What will be the formula? You can take ClF, ClF3, ClF5, ClF7. Right? Same way BrF, BrF3, BrF5 and BrF7. Same way IF3, IF7, IF5. Right? So this is all the elements can combine with fluorine because fluorine is at the top having more electronegativity. Okay, next combination, let us see. Chlorine can combine with bromine and chlorine can combine with iodine. If chlorine combines with bromine, what will you get? BrCl3, BrCl5, BrCl7, right? Even BrCl is also possible. Okay, Br can combine with chlorine, even iodine can combine with chlorine. What will be the compounds? Iodines chloride, iodine trichloride, iodine pentachloride and iodine heptachloride. Next combination, let us see. Iodine bromine combining with iodine. If bromine combines with iodine, who is at the center? Iodine is at the center and bromine is at the outside or periphery. Iodine bromide, iodine tribromide, iodine pentabromide and iodine heptabromide. These are interhalogen compounds. In these, monohalide means the compound is linear, trihalide means trigonal planar, and this is trigonal bipyramidal, and this is octahedral bipyramidal. Right? These are the different shapes of interhalogen compounds. In the next class, we will look at different compounds of halogens. Okay, thank you.